Okay, shalom, Ishi, shalom Rastafari. Now, the question that we're going to seek to give a more affirmative answer towards and to provide ones and ones, you know, the proof, right, the proof of the truth is concerning the little book of His Majesty, right, the little book of His Majesty, which we know as the FIKARE IYESUS, right? We want to bring up a particular imagery right here, right? A particular imagery right here. You've seen the different images of Nibiru, all right? And this is some of them right here, different images of Nibiru. Now, in the Ethiopic, there's a book. We don't have, we might have it, but we might need to look through what we have, right? And Nibiru, right, which is also called, now, you know, Alexander, you understand, Alexander Sitchin, I think he's passed away, it seems so, because someone's talking about him as though he's passed away, right, don't know too much about him, but may Jah have mercy on his soul as well. It's non-partial when you recognize how precious redemption is. You understand? Is Nibiru in the FIKARE IYESUS, right? The little book of His Imperial Majesty. Let's use this right here, right? Is Nibiru, right? Is Nibiru mentioned in this particular book, the FIKARE IYESUS? Now, we're going to go to a particular passage of here that we're going to translate, right, and try to deal basically raw word for word, right? It's FIKARE IYESUS. Now, we know that FIKARE IYESUS, right, according to the information we have here, I'll read it for the eye, right? We can use some other pictures of Nibiru, because Nibiru is interesting because it looks like Hathor, in a sense. It looks like the symbology from the Egyptian mystery or the mystery schools, right? It has wings, almost like horns. It has particular horns. So, and it's called the Passover comet, or the angel, the destroyer. It's also known as the destroyer. Now, here in the FIKARE IYESUS, we find a passage. Let's bring that particular passage up here, right? And let's get a little more length on this right here. Now, it's on page 13. So, let's go to page 13, this is page 12 right here, and it's very interesting. Well, let's go to the beginning of this passage. So we're going to go to right here on the bottom of 12, right? It says Geta, right, Hawariyatin Bedebra Zayit said Bisbuacho Sale Behalinyo Zemin Bemimet Al Tulid Yemiya Derago, right? Yemi Derago. Let's go to the next page. Milikitu Minderno. Is key Nigeren below Getachinen Lemenut. So the disciples, right? The disciples, when they were on, basically the raw translation, when they was on the mount, when they were gathered, right, you know, when he gathered them, when they were gathered on the Mount of Deborah Zait, or the Mount of Olives, right, it speaks to us, and it says that the disciple, or the, it says the Hawariyat, the apostles here, that they had acts, and we have that in Matthew chapter 24, you understand, something similar to that, but here we have the Hawariyat. They had asked the same question, like in the last age, right? That, you know, that which will come on the generation of the last age, you know, what is his sign, or what is the sign? They didn't say what is your sign, but Milikitu, what is his sign, or what is the sign? Because it's not really definite articles by Marinha, but they can be interpreted, so it can mean his, or it can mean the, according to its context. They said, Minderno, What is it? It's Ki Nigeren. It's Ki Nigeren below, right? Getachnen, our Lord, our Master, Lemenut. Lemenut. Lemenute, right? And it says, Getam, and the Adoni, and the Geta, the self restrained one, Melesalacho, Alacho Wim. Wedajoche Hoi, O my lovers, those who love me, right? The Hawariyat and all of us, he considers to be lovers or even friends, you can say. Behwalenyao Zemin, Lemi Metau Kufat, Milikit, in the last Zemin, the last age, or the final age, the latter age, right? For that which comes, the evil sign, the evil sign. Here it says, Jeratama, Kokeb, Yefetaral, right? Yefetaral. It's like, it says, Jeratama, a star, right? A star that has a tail, a Jerat, that has a tail. This is what's interesting, the detail, right? Jeratama, right? No pun intended, Jeratama. Right, Kokeb, Yefetera, will be created, right? It says it will be created. You know, they said Nibiru originally was called a black star. Nibiru, right? Nibiru was originally called a black star. And we have some other pictures of it, what it's said to look like and what is testified among many peoples. You know, among many peoples. In their own shamanic, Shem traditions, you understand, of those who God considers to be the revealers or the prophets for their people, the warners among all people. You also remember the love of humanity. They all are his creatures, and he want to give them the opportunity of becoming his sons and daughters, even as we are his sons and daughters. So it says, Jaratama, that Nibiru, right, is said to have a tail. And we're not going to go through all the detail of it, you understand, no pun intended, all the detail of Nibiru, you understand, because there's a lot of information out there. But what we found to be very interesting in the FIKARE IYESUS, which was published in the 43rd year of His Imperial Majesty's reign on the throne of David, which is the throne of Exiarihel, the throne of Jehovah, Yahweh, in Ethiopia, which is the African Ethiopian. And all this was prior to whom His Majesty identified in 1941 as the godless and cruel dragon. People thought His Majesty was maybe fantasizing or indulging in too much parabolics. Uh-huh. But no way. You know what I'm saying? He said what it is true. And it is true what he said. The godless and the cruel dragon. And they are the ones behind the so-called creeping coup against Christ and his kingly character and the end of the world. If Babylon ever should even want to raise its voice against His Majesty, as they are going to, you're going to see the sign just increase manifold. You know what I'm saying? You're going to see certain hits. And this is one reason why they don't. Because we always wonder why, how come they don't say anything about His Majesty? No, they already published Is God Dead. Remember, in the same time as the revolution against Haile Selassie. How interesting. They already went against, like, God in the classroom in that same time period. You know what I'm saying? Are these things related? So Christ here in the FIKARE IYESUS, he says, Jaratama Kokeb Yifetara. Yan Gizeh, that time, Beyagaru, Yan Gizeh, Beyagaru, Chink Yehona, that in that time, Beyagaru, in each country, right, Chink, difficult times, Chink, difficult or perilous times. You know in your Bible where it says perilous times, hard to deal with? It uses that same word. It uses that very same word, you understand? Hard times or difficult times to deal with. And it's not so much 2012 2012 is a sign, but it's really 2013. You know, what we really got to look out for, you understand? We got to really look out for 2013. You understand? We got to prepare ourselves in that sense spiritually, really, against 2013. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, it speaks about the apostasy, that the Mitmanon's resource, our resource as faithful and true, is the scriptures. That's all we have to hear the word, surround ourselves with the hearing of the word from this ministry and other ministries. Even just get one of those kind of CDs where they just read the Bible. Just read through the Bible or whatnot like that. So you can put that deposit, you understand? So you can invest that in your spiritual bank. So the inner technology, the wisdom can work in its right time. Don't rely too much on the outer technology, you know, or don't deep end. It says, this know also, we're to know this, not to guess it. I guess we're in the last, no, you better know it. You understand? That in the last days, perilous times shall come, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy. It's interesting that in 1974, 75, Ethiopia, we get this sign. And these are the same things that were going on at that time. And they can only be overcome by repentance. By repentance. Chronicles. What Solomon's prayer in Chronicles is the prayer for Ethiopia, right? People who are called by my name. You understand? That prayer there. Without natural affection. So a bunch of unnatural stuff going on. Truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good. There's one that despise I for this ministry. I mean, despise. We're not talking about envious or jealous. That's another kind. You understand? But despise I, you understand, for this ministry. Because they are the despisers of those that are good, and they despise you too when you start to declare these truths. You didn't do one. You know, when we were in our old self, we would lay hands on them, and not to baptize them or to, we would baptize them, but it was a whole different order there. You know what I'm saying? And now they will show you how despicable they are. Verse 4, traitors. They're traitors. We see this happen in Ethiopia in this time. This is why Abba covers his face right there, as it says in Hosea. You understand? He covers, he hides his face, his glory. You understand? Because when you read that God cannot tolerate evil, he cannot abide with evil because he is Kedus. You understand? Even Abba Kedus. So in his mercy, he gives them time to work out, you know, work out what they're dealing with, to overcome Satan, right, to repent. Traitors, heady, they're high-minded, right? Lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. And now, this does not mean that we should not have pleasure. You understand? He wants us to be happy, you understand, in him and in true things. But don't love the pleasures more than you love Jah. Remember, it's Jah who giveth you these pleasures, or even the sensation and perception to feel these sort of pleasures. You understand? Let's recognize, right? He created wonderfully and fearfully we are created. You understand? So he gives us the ability to feel and to have pleasure. But don't love the pleasure more than you love Jah, and you don't give him thanks. You understand? And do it in his order. You understand? In his spirit, in his way, with a clear conscience. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. They look like a godly one, you know what I mean? They look like a priest and the priestess and all of this. They have a form of godliness, but they deny the what? The Haile. They deny my God. Elohe. They deny Elohe. They deny Haile. They deny his majesty. Right? From such, turn away. Now, y'all be spending time like you're trying to convince them because they're relative, they're family, or they're this or that. You know, and that just shows that either you know what Christ says there, but you're not doing it. You know, and he likens you to a fool. You know what I'm saying? They say that God has mercy on babies and fools. I don't know what I haven't found that verse. Can you give me the verse in the scripture on that?
You know what I'm saying? That's not, you know, that's not there. That's not his word. That's somebody else's word. You know what I'm saying? I don't trust someone else other than Yeshua. You know what I'm saying? Other than Yitach and Jesus Christos. And neither should you, if you're my brothers and sisters. For of this sort are they which creep into houses. Now, when it says houses, it's talking about churches. It's talking about the bait. You know what I'm saying? They creep into houses. And what they do? And they lead captive silly woman laden with sins. Now, it's not just talking about outer women. It's talking about them too, but it's talking about some effeminate men. That means the men who are not really manning up in Yeshua HaMoshiach. You know what I'm saying? Because Yeshua will show us what being a man is like. And lead captive silly woman laden with sins, led away with diverse lusts. So it's not just talking about females, but in the spiritual, it's talking about the feminine men, and it goes into that. You understand? Scripture speaks about that. You understand? Men who are not taking the true headship because they're not receiving Yeshua HaMoshiach as their head. You understand? They have other people bossing them around. You understand? Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. You know, the knowledge of the Onet. Even the acting on that knowledge. They're learning a lot of stuff. They got a lot. They've been studying this for years. And still they cannot clearly say that Yeshua HaMoshiach, you understand, is the Son of the living God. You understand? And accept him and recognize that he's our Lord and Savior. All right? So not to go off into that, you understand, scripture. Keep that as a scripture and refer to it. We just was trying to highlight that word chink. Right, that word chink right there. I think Bamarinya is chink. So it says shum, right? So these are the things, this is going to be perilous times in this particular time. Now, some say that the comet might have been hale-bopp, right? The hale-bopp comet. You understand? Hale-bopp, right? You remember a couple of years ago, all those people in that cult, they killed themselves and stuff like that. You understand? Thinking they're going to catch a ride on the tail end of the comet. Because what kind of comet was it? You understand? What kind of comet was it? You understand? It was a comet that had a what? That had a tail. You understand? That had a tail. You understand? This particular tail right here says, Jaratama Kokeb Yifetara. So it says, in this time, there's going to be perilous time in nations. They call it the Cold War, but it was a hot war for many ones and ones. It was a very hot war. It says Shum Kashum. And where Shum is like an appointed and elected, you understand, official, from elected official, you understand, or one who is appointed. Now, when you look at this, all right, when you look at this in the sense of Ethiopia and what was going on in the time that this book was revealed, this little book of His Majesty, it becomes even more interesting. You know what I'm saying? And you find more direct evidence. You know what I'm saying? Direct evidence that this is the time. This is the time. Shum ka shum. Negush ka negush. Yitalam. And this is what happened in Ethiopia. You know what I'm saying? This is exactly what happened in Ethiopia. And you see it right there? Right? This is exactly what happened in Ethiopia. That one who received appointment were against others who received appointment. They, you know, and some actually violated the Constitution and got medals and joined secret societies of other countries, which is against the Ethiopian Constitution. You know what I'm saying? The Imperial Constitution. So we talk about traitors and heady people. You know what I'm saying? Saying the old man is the one that sent them to school, and now they know better than the old man. You know what I'm saying? Like, brought Ethiopia from, like, the 17th or so century, you understand? 16th or 17th, actually, century to the 21st century. You know what I'm saying? And the old man, right? The old man didn't know what he was doing. You know what I'm saying? But no, it's been proven now as we move into a period of, you know, how many years later? How many years is it from 75 or so? You understand? How many years would that be? 20, 25, well, 35, 35, 6, 7, like 37 or so? Almost 37 years later. You understand? Well, what is this hour of tribulation? Can we calculate this? Well, let's get this other verse
and just prove this matter right here. It says, Beredona, Beredona, right? Beredona, Dinga, Yisatina, Din, Amedim, Yizenma. Now, that seems like common stuff today. You know, it's almost like when you hear it, like, oh, there it goes again. Another mountain erupting. You know, when would this stop? You know, don't be like those in the Sakura. Beredo is like hail, and Dingai, stone, Isat, right? Hail and stone, stones of fire, like symbolizing like volcanic type activity. Din, right, which is sulfur, right? The din is sulfur, right? Right. It's interesting. Din, I think, is sulfur. Amedim, and ashes, Yizendama, that these things will rain down. You know, there's been some very interesting volcanoes in Ethiopia at some very interesting times, too. You know, it will rain down. So this star that has a tail, and before we get out of this reasoning right here, or go forward from this reason, let's see if we could bring down some of these images right here, and if we can get to, right, if we can get to some of the images right here. Because we had the image of the 8th millennia, right? The 8th millennia Kokeb, right? Some of the images of the 8th millennia Kokeb. That's what it's called Ethiopically, right? The star, right, of the 8th, right, millennium. Because the Ethiopian calculation, if I'm correct, is going into what, 7505, right, or 7,000 year, right, the 7,000 year. So here we have, right, here we have, see if there's some of that light right there so one can see it fully. All right, here we have the Simentenyao Shi Kokeb, or the Kokeb of the 8th millennium. Now, if a day with the Lord is 1,000 years, just follow me on this math and, you know, check it out for yourself. If a day with the Lord is 1,000 years, if there's 12 hours in a day, right? So how long would an hour be? Our calculation of how long an hour would be is something roughly in the order of 83 years. So when we look at coming up November 2nd, right, how many years since the Ameta Bejwa? Now, over is what I'm saying right here. How many years? Let's see if we can bring this up right here. Remember the Kishate Burhan? Right? The Kishate Burhan. Now, this was published right here in the 63rd year, 63 AB. It's kind of worn out. Tarsus, which is roughly December of 1993. Right? We call it the Ameta Bejwa. Right, the Ameta Bejwa, because His Majesty is the kinsman redeemer, right, of the true and the ethnic Beta Israel. We're not speaking of spiritual Israel, which are the true Christians. You know, saying are truly spiritual Israel, but we are talking about the racial, the ethnic, you know, not the counterfeit sign, but the true sign of the King of Kings, right, upon the throne of David with that scepter. You know, saying that scepter or that rod, you know, saying that rod in his hand, you know, saying that rod of rulership that the English or the British, you know, saying had to restore. So here we're looking at, right, here we're looking at this from some Ethiopian sources, putting together some of the various Nibiru. You understand, this is that, you see, there's like that star, right? It's a star, and it has a Jaratama star. Now, when you study the whole Nibiru, what Nibiru is, it's said to be a black star, right? But even that black star carries, you understand, a certain amount of debris. There's a certain amount of debris that follows and that it pulls, right, into its orbit. Some of the artists' versions of it are like this. But if you look at other artistic representations, right, you're going to get other interesting images of it, and there's also testimony that says it has horns. Now, this would be very interesting with the golden calf, because the people mistook, right, that heavenly sign, right, for the false religion, you understand, the falsified version of the religion. Because, see, what happened in ancient Egypt is like what's happening in the Christian churches, you understand, and what has happened in the Christian churches. Yes, they are Christian, but they're not in the true Christ. They're more after Caesar's order, you understand, than Yeshua's order. Whenever it comes into a conflict between what the world thinks, right, and what Caesar thinks, they always do what Caesar. So it shows that whole thing about the two masters. So when now this is showing you the size, this is Earth right here, right? This is the sun, size, approximate size of the sun, and this is that dark star right here. It was called a black star. But then too many black folks said fear of the black planet. And as soon as we said fear of the black planet, they started to call it a small brown dwarf star. You understand? A so-called dwarf star, right? But it's very clear that is it really that much of a dwarf when you see its size comparable with the Earth, right? The size comparable with the Earth. Now notice that here's Cheres, right? And that is very interesting because Cheres, right, is also, you have to remember, is a name for the sun too, right? If you look in the Hebrew, Keres or Cheres. Right, but anyway, this is the Nibiru. You understand? This is another example, or we can say, representation of the solar system and where we're at right now. So when we look into the FIKARE IYESUS and find that the FIKARE IYESUS actually makes mention of this, and remember, it was published roughly 1973. Right, maybe 74, leaning into 74. All depends on the more exact date. I think they just give us a year. They don't give us an exact date. So now this is running around the heavens. In other words, this is moving around the orbit of the heavens, right? And because it's a very thick, dense, you understand, body, much more denser than the Earth, it doesn't have to come even very close for its effects, right, for its real-time effects to be manifested on the Earth, causing things like earthquakes. You're saying causing the sun to even rise in the southern direction. You understand? And I think within the FIKARE IYESUS, if I'm correct, I even read that there. And some of that would have seemed to people, you understand, who were worldly and had no faith in God's word, they would have thought that was fantasy. You understand, fantasy, okay, this is a religious book, but it's kind of like it's talking about something else. They would have misinterpreted it. They would have not accepted it to be literally, you understand, what it says it's saying. But now we know better. Now the FIKARE IYESUS being revealed in that very prophetic age and time, during the time of the creeping coup. So as Madsey warned in 1941, right, he warned us, he warned them, he warned all of us about the godless and the cruel dragon. And now we know that he was not speaking any hyperbole. You understand? He was not speaking just in a symbolic way. You understand? So once again, we can recognize that the knowledge of the King of Kings is superlative. You understand? It's not to be, you know, dumbed down. You understand? If you don't know, you don't know. But don't assume. You understand? Don't assume, because you only make an ass out of yourself, not out of the King of Kings. So the King of Kings' testimony, we see in this particular time, is being vindicated by the evidence. Now, how amazing is that right there? That's something that was published in 1973, and we have one of the published copies of it, like, let's say, original copy. We've even seen an older copy. We have some video of that as well, an older copy of it. Yehovah's. Now, how interesting that that would be, that little book. And that little book, right in the beginning of it, this is bring that up for the people right here. Right in the beginning of it, and here's the key word, here's the key phrase, these three words, Jaratama, Kokeb, Yefetara. You understand? That a star with a tail will be created. So whether this is speaking about hale-bopp, the hale-bopp comet, or whether it's speaking about Nibiru, you understand? We both see that the hale-bopp was a little before Nibiru, you understand? But it's like the hale-bopp, in a sense, signaled, it seems like Nibiru. You understand? The man is learning more and more about the various different orbits, you understand, of these particular heavenly bodies. So what we're coming into right now, let's move it right here, is this painting right here, which speaks about this spiritual warfare that's going on. Now, if we take the 12 hours of the day, right, and we say 1/12 of a 1,000 years, what would 1/12 be? It would be about 83 or so years, 1/12, with a small fraction of remainder left over, right? 83 years. So now when you take November 2nd as a starting point for we as Black Beta Israel, for our redemption as a people, our sovereignty, our divine heritage, you understand, that will, that covenant, you understand, being fulfilled in our kinsman redeemer, you understand, in our Boaz, you understand, he is our Ethiopian Boaz, the King of Kings, Kedamawi Haile Selassie, and check out I and I book on Ruth, you understand, on Ruth, the study of Ruth that we did. It's just one layer of it, you understand, like an onion being peeled forward, you understand, but check it out on our books page, Herut, or Ruth, because he is our heavenly Boaz, right? And we have 83, right? 83 and 1930, when we do the math, right? When we do the math, we have 2000, right? We have 2013. Right, we have 2013. So if we just take the Psalms right here, 1:12 and 1:13, we're going to just close out on this. So that 83 seems to be that hour. You see, what we're in and what we've been in is that hour. Some people think it's a literal hour. There's a sign of the Twin Towers coming down in an hour. You understand? Because there are many signs that the Almighty, because of his abundant love that he has for us, and being a love of humanity, he gives us many different signs. You understand? Overlapping signs, fractal signs. You understand? He almost like the, you know, a small piece of the big picture. So it's really 2013 that we have to prepare our hearts, minds, and our spirits for. It's really 2013. You know, so many have already talked about how the whole 2012 thing is almost like kind of a false. It's been hyped up so that people, when they don't see that many things happening, they will go back to sleep. You understand? They will go back to sleep. And all these monies that you see being robbed out of the economy, you understand, and nobody knows where it's going. Well, you know, a lot of folks know where it's going, you understand, because they are also on their guard about the Kokeb, the star of the 8th millennium, you understand, and they're preparing themselves, you understand. Some folks got an island. How you get that? Wow, you asked God for the island? How did you do that? No, you didn't? So you're a thief. Anyway, the islands and all those going to be moved out of its place. And I really pray for the brothers and sisters, even in the Caribbean, though some think, you know, whatever they think. But a lot of us are in areas that really are not very good. But this don't mean that we should fear or run to the hills. So it says, not with haste. You understand? By that time, he does say to go to a higher ground. So we're going to have to seek to network about sanctuary and get our spiritual house in order. That will make the preparation easier. And though others were preparing for decades, Jah will prepare things wonderfully for I and I if we get first things first. So for 2012 and 2013, let's just deal with these two psalms. So our calculation is that this hour period of time can roughly be summed up into this 83-year period, 2012 in 2013, marking it from that acceptable day of the Lord. And what was that acceptable day of the Lord? November 2nd. You know, the acceptable year of the Lord? November 2nd. Remember Christ, when he was in the synagogue, he read, the synagogue of Nazareth, he read part of it. And then he closed the book halfway between. And if you go to that part about the acceptable year of the Lord, and you check the footnote, that is to be fulfilled. So this is what we're on the cusp of this second part being fulfilled. So let's go through this psalm right here, Psalm 112. And that's what we meant by the hour. You understand? You understand that it is hour of tribulation. In fact, we've been going through this hour of tribulation ever since 1930. So this hour of tribulation. You know what I'm saying? So there's some hour that manifest kedusha, so how do I unlock? Hallelujah. Blessed is the man that feareth the King of Kings, right? Blessed is the man that feareth, that is truly Rastafari. Let's overstand that. Let's bring up the Fikare Iyesus, right? The Fikare. Let's just bring up Father, right? All right. Blesses the man. So we can see that this 8th millennial Kokeb, remember what it says? In his splendor, likened to the sun, right? In his exalted power to the lion, in his divine person to the kings of Israel, and sometimes to God himself. Well, brothers and sisters, this is one of those times. So hallelujah, blessed is the man that reverences, right, that feareth the King of Kings, that is truly Rastafari, that delighteth greatly in his commands. His seed, his race, right, shall be mighty upon the earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed, shall be Baruch. Wealth and riches shall be in his house, and his righteousness endureth, right? His righteousness endureth forever, because his righteousness is of Yeshua. His righteousness is of God in Christ. You always, let's bring this right here. You could even bring in that other one, but we just want to show this right here, right? His righteousness is Yeshua is our righteousness, not our self-righteousness. It's by grace that we are saved, by amen, and with our innate, you know what I'm saying, our subjective faith on the object of the faith that we behold in spirit, spiritually, word, sound, power, and in truth, and the reality of the Ethiopian problem. So his righteousness endureth forever. To the upright there ariseth light in the darkness. To the upright there ariseth light in the darkness. There's illumination, there's clarity in this ignorance. He is gracious, full of compassion, and righteous and tzaddik. A good man showeth favor and lendeth. You know, you see his majesty giving out the money, and all these testimonies of how he freely gave out money to different works and projects. You understand? And he lendeth, he gaveth. He will guide his affairs with discretion. Surely, or amen, he shall not be moved forever. He shall not be moved forever. The righteous or tzaddik
shall be in everlasting or eternal remembrance. You see, they're going to have to get tired to see Japheth. They can't get him out of his place. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed. You remember during the revolution, they were saying, oh, His Majesty wasn't acting like he didn't put down the revolution. He didn't sick the dogs on the people, on his children. You know, they say he was senile. No, he was not afraid. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed, trusting in Yahweh, trusting in He who is who He is. His heart is established. He shall not be afraid. So notice the main message in this psalm for 2012 is no fear, not being afraid, your heart being firm, being grounded on that foundation, building on that rock, until he sees his desire upon his enemies, until he sees his desires upon the Satanat that sought to rob we the black people of our Davidic kingdom, of our African of Zion. Yovas, he hath dispersed, he hath given to the poor, as I and I were poor. You understand? And His Majesty has given to us. You understand? And He took off all of those robes of regalness. You understand? And put on that Bahitawi, that singularity of His divinity, that Abba Kedusinet. Right? It says that His right.